everyone, and welcome to CCTV. I'm your host, Conrad Angel Corral. Today we come to you from the future site of the Cathedral Canyon Bridge project, a long overdue solution to the flooding and road closures that we get here when we have our heavy rains. And yes, we do get heavy rains here in the desert. To speak to us about bridges and road improvement projects, I'll be back at City Hall to speak to some folks who are in the know. It is safe to say that I survived the heat outside, and I'm now here inside of the city studios to talk to our first guest, City Engineer John Corella. Thank you for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
So before we talk everything road improvement project oriented, let's get to know a little bit about you. So how long have you been with the city, and what are some of the job responsibilities associated with being a city engineer?
Well, city engineer takes care of quite a few things. I manage a department that takes care of not only our capital improvement program, which we often refer to as CIP, which is our big projects that we do over the course of many years.
So let's talk about road improvement projects. So it is my understanding we have past projects that are already completed, which I understand some or many came in under budget and ahead of schedule.
Yes.
And then we have some projects that are currently going on and some that we're going to be seeing in the future. I'm just going to take those one at a time. So let's talk about projects that have already happened. Why don't you tell us, were two, three, four, how many of those were out there?
Well, first off, just a while back, we completed the rubberizing of East Palm Canyon with rubberized pavement from city limit to city limit. That was a big accomplishment.
And that helps the environment also, or does that just make the road smoother, or both?
It actually serves a couple functions. One is we used recycled rubber products on the roadway. Mm-hmm. In addition, it's actually a good binder and holds the roadway together. In addition to that, it makes your ride smoother and quieter. Rubber on rubber will make a quieter ride.
I say yes, yes, yes to all of those.
There you go.
Works for me.
We also just completed a large project using a rubber product on the asphalt, and that is the Vista Chino pavement rehabilitation project. And that was 2 miles, a $3.5 million project.
Wow.
From city limit to the west at the Whitewater River all the way to Date Palm. In addition to that, we did two large long lengths of residential streets, Avenida La Vista and Avenida La Paz, that reconstructed their entire roadway system. We did not use a rubber product there, because in residential streets, the speeds aren't as high, you don't necessarily need that product.
So let me ask you a question about this rubberized product. Is this some kind of product that a lot of cities are now bringing to their roads, or is this something that Cathedral City is doing kind of as a leader?
We've always been the leader in using rubber products. In fact, a lot of agencies call us and see how they're holding up, especially in this desert climate that tends to be very harsh.
If you can survive it here, you can survive.
We also get rubber recycling grants. So on the Vista Chino project, we received over $100,000 in rebates, in grants, from the Rubber Tire Recycling Institute.
Now, the projects that went on, that we're talking about right now, are those projects that a constituent called in and said, hey, there's too many potholes, we need a new road, someone come out and look at it? Is it something that you're out finding these projects and then bringing them back to council? How does that work? I don't think a lot of people know much about it.
It's a combination of both, and I'll even add, it's council members citing that the roads might need some improvement, take a look at them. It's internal staff. Constituents are probably our number one reminder of a roadway needing attention, and ourselves, we also go around the city on an annual basis and we perform what we call a pavement condition index rating, and we go around to all the streets and we essentially rate them on their condition and when they're going to need refurbishing.
Now, I would think that a variety of residents who are in the area may think, right now, I'm going to call City Hall right now because my road needs a whatever. So if a constituent calls in like that, how far into the future does that project, if it's approved, happen? Can it be tomorrow, or can it be a year or so from now?
Well, if you're fortunate enough to call in and complain about a street's condition, a lot of times they're on the winner's list because we've already budgeted for that street. Okay. We've seen that challenge, and there's funds available in
that
area.
So you're out there looking anyways.
We're looking anyway. But a lot of times, residents bring it to our attention. It's been lower on our list, and we go out there and take a second look. You know, we have over 20 million square feet of roadway in this city, and it's really hard for all of us staff, seven people, to go out there and monitor the roadways while doing our functions in the office. We rely on the constituents of the city to really provide us the best information on what's happening out there.
And this is proof that this is your city, so all you need to do is ask,
inquire. Absolutely. Right? Now, they may not get the answer they want in the timeliness they want, but it does get noted. We have a list, and we make sure that we're monitoring that. And we, once again, it goes on that pavement condition index list.
So we talked about Vista Chino, and was there another project?
Avenue La Vista, Avenue La Paz, they just got completed.
Okay.
Now we're moving into, we are under construction on another major project this summer, and that is a 3-mile project, which is all of Avenue 30 from Landau to Duval Road. That will be totally reconstructed, as well as McCallum, which from Landau to Date Palm will be totally reconstructed.
So let me ask you a question. What about road closures? How does that work?
Road closures are a dynamic situation, and we always encourage our constituents that when there's a construction project, respect the fact that there are men out there working, men and women working out there, and that their safety is one of our primary concerns, as well as your safety as a motorist. So we always encourage them to slow down.
And as residents, I think we need to remember, long term is what we're looking. We may be going through something now, but in the long term, roads are going to be better, places are going to be better. Talk future. What kind of future road improvement projects do we have coming?
We have, usually in the, because we use rubberized products, they need to be applied in the cooler weather months. They do have a challenge with being applied in our summer months here because they are temperature dependent. And we have a number of rubberized slurry projects that we do in neighborhoods where the streets can take that product coming up in the late fall, starting in mid-October. And we're going to do a significant amount of work up in the Cathedral City Cove area, an area right near Nellie Kaufman School, Avenue 35, in that residential area. And then in the spring, we're going to be looking at doing a little more major work, probably up in the Rio Vista area, if we can actually do RIAS in the fall there.
So we talked about past, current, and future. We got them all?
I think so.
All right, sounds good. So when you're out at a bar or at a dinner talking with friends and someone says, what are they doing there? You now will be in the know. So we've learned about road improvement projects. Let's talk bridges. We're going to talk bridges with our next guest, Community Development Director Pat Miles. Thank you for joining us here today.
Thank you for having me.
So let's start with something easy. Tell us a little about how long you've been here with the city and what are some of the job responsibilities that you have?
Oh, I started at the city about 12 years ago, and I came onto the city as the public works manager. So I did that job for about 8 years, and then the last 4 or 5 years, I've been the community development director. Mm-hmm. Basically, what my job is to oversee the engineering, planning, and building departments, as well as code compliance. So it's really a job that covers quite a few of the disciplines of the city.
Sounds like it. So let's talk bridges now.
Okay.
And this would be kind of general at the beginning. Why don't you tell us a little bit about what, I believe there's 3 projects that are out there that are bridge projects coming to us or currently happening. Tell us the name of those projects and where they're located at.
Okay. Currently, what the public will see and what they'll be mostly impacted is the Date Palm Bridge Widening Project. That project actually is probably in its 5th year of actual work. With these bridges, a lot of the time is in the preparation before you ever see the construction, and that includes getting clearances from the Army Corps of Engineer, acquiring right-of-way, working with other agencies to make sure that all of the environmental processes are taken care of, as well as developing a funding source for the final construction of the bridges.
But we're now seeing that now.
We're actually at the point now where we're going into the construction. So I think a lot of people have a misconception that you get funding and you just start working on a bridge, but it actually is pretty intensive process, because part of the funding is federal, so it requires a whole myriad of additional layers of what I would call environmental bureaucracy to go through to protect the public and to protect the environment. So,
and just in case someone hasn't been on that, on Date Palm, that is north of 111 and south of Gerald Ford.
Ford.
Right, okay, so we know where that is. Right.
Yeah, and that bridge has been in existence for a while. It's gone through a couple of seismic events. And so this project will widen it to a full width and add bicycle lanes and walking lanes on either side. So it should be a much safer bridge. The bridge, as it is now, if you're traveling north and you're in the number two lane, you're right up against the guardrail. And we've actually had accidents where people broke the guardrail and, you know, they didn't go into the wash, but could have gone into the wash. But the good part of when you see construction on a bridge, that means it's in its final phases. So on that one, we expect that to be complete, open to the public, and in both directions, and the ribbon put on that and the bow put on it, probably in the end of 2018.
There, and it seems to be moving very quickly. And there's a lot of stuff. There's a lot of people out there at all times.
And actually, the way that we try to set up our projects is there's kind of an incentive for the general contractor to move at a rapid pace through it.
And I just said that they're there at all times, but they're not there at all times.
No.
When do projects start? When can they start working? And then when is there a, they can't work any later than?
We do have codes that relate to that. We normally in the summer months allow them to start at, I believe it's 5 and be done by 5 in the afternoon. Okay. And in the winter months, I think it goes from 6 to 7 or 8 o'clock. So there are periods that they will ask us if they can work out of those hours, and depending upon the safety issues surrounding that, we sometimes will allow that.
But are they Monday through Friday, or can they work on the weekends also?
They are Monday through Friday, but I believe they can work on the weekends if they can get permission from the city engineer.
Okay, so let's talk about where we started our show today, and that's over at the Cathedral Canyon Bridge Project. Why don't you tell us about when that's going to start and what are we going to see there?
Well, I've had a lot of questions on why the Cathedral Canyon Bridge wasn't started before the Date Palm Bridge. And there really is a pretty practical answer to that. Again, these projects take a lot of time in the pre-design stages. Cathedral Canyon Bridge, as you know, is a new bridge. So that actually requires a little, quite a bit more environmental work. Quite a bit more of getting right-of-ways and making sure that the land that we're putting the bridge over, that, you know, it's, their clearances are there for that.
And before you go on, so everyone knows what we're talking about, I call it the dip. What are those areas?
It's called a low water crossing, basically, and it's between Perez Road and south of Dinosaur.
And if you've been there, when it's been through there when it's raining, you know that there's road closures and there's flooding all the time. So this is going to be a resolution to that.
Yeah, this is actually going to be another one of our goals, was to connect the north city to the southern parts of the city. And both of these bridge projects will accomplish that. Mm-hmm. Not only for automobile traffic, but also for foot traffic, as well as recreational traffic, bicycles, that kind of thing.
And those are our two main roads, north and south?
There really are our two main roads, and actually Date Palm gets a little more traffic on it. It's a truck route, but Cathedral Canyon is an important link from the north city to the south city.
All right, and let's talk now about Ramon Bridge Project. Where is that going to be at?
Ramon Road Bridge Project is actually on the western border of our of Cathedral City and Palm Springs, excuse me.
So that is that main larger bridge over by the bowling alley and that space.
Right.
Okay.
It runs from the bowling alley, and actually the city of Cathedral City runs to San Luis Rey on the north side of Ramon Road.
Oh, is that right? Interesting. Because I was driving there the other day and I saw a sign on this side where the bowling alley is, but I didn't look on the other side to see whether, I just assumed half of the bridge is Cathedral City, the other half is Palm Springs.
The southern half is Palm Springs, the northern half is Cathedral City, all the way to San Luis Rey. Actually, Palm Springs' border comes right up to the bowling alley. So a lot of people always ask, well, you know, why is the city not involved in that land south of the bridge? And the easy answer is because it's actually in Palm Springs' sphere of influence.
So will this project be a co-city project?
It is a joint project. Palm Springs is the lead agency on it, so they're more involved in the preparation work, which is, again, getting the environmental issues squared away, getting the right-of-way squared away, coming up with a funding mechanism to pay for it. And in all three of these cases, there's federal money involved. So in all three cases, a little more scrutiny, a little more of a layer of bureaucracy and environmental work to be done.
It just made me think, especially for that bridge there, the Dinosaur Bridge, mm-hmm. right? That's such a, well, I remember when that first came in, there was really not much there, but a beautiful bridge to cross. Uh-huh. And now, of course, the world has come around that uh-huh. space. Will that type of beauty be brought to any of these bridges? Or
actually, yes. And in all three cases, part of our challenge and part of our charge, not only for the engineering department, but for the city as a whole, is to beautify the entrances into town, to make these practical apparatuses more appealing, to soften them to some extent, to not just make them functional, but also make them fashionable and to look nice, have to give the city a spirit of community, as well as to improve the appearance of the city and to improve the entrances into the city. So in all three cases, you'll see a lot of landscaping involved with the bridges, but the city will also take a step past that and beyond that, and we'll involve our arts commission in installing some sculptures. We'll also take a good long look at how the entrance into Perez Road is going to look, how the entrance coming off of Cathedral Canyon will look, and we're also trying to incorporate the Cathedral City bike trail in all three of these bridges. Mm. So that they can be links on and off of the Cathedral City Bike Trail, the future CV link.
Does the CV link at all hit any of that?
Hits all three of them.
So it does mm-hmm. hit all three of them.
Actually hits, there's a fourth bridge that actually is in the preliminary stages, and that's actually a bridge over the Morongo Wash on Vista Chino from Cathedral City to Palm Springs. Mm. And actually it will touch that bridge as well. So as the CV link is developed, each one of these bridges will be impacted or be a jump on, jump off point for the CV link.
Interesting.
And incorporate that, not only the what in California we've always focused on, the car traffic, but also the recreational traffic, the foot traffic, and try to bring the, like I said before, to connect this, make the city's connectivity much better, not only for recreation, but for the motoring public. And I think that once they're built, the community will, there'll be something that will be functional, but the community will be proud of them
and
as well.
Did we talk about when the Ramon Bridge project will end, or estimated?
No, Date Palm will be done the winter of 18. We're hoping that Cathedral Canyon Bridge will be under construction early next spring, next summer, and that would be possibly done the winter of 19. And I think Ramon Road Bridge is tentatively slated for about the same time.
Okay.
What we are trying to avoid is any conflict that it could be caused by having them all under construction at
right.
the same time.
Right.
We want them to the projects to move along as quickly as possible. So it's about safety and functionality, but it's also about convenience. We do want to take that as one of our considerations: the convenience to the public, the convenience to the people that are near these construction
sites. Right,
which is
very important.
Yeah.
I want to thank you for bringing
mm-hmm.
us up to date on everything that there is bridges. I want to thank, of course, City Engineer John Corella for talking to us about road improvement projects. And now it's safe to say that you are in the know. I'm Conrad Angel Corella, your host. I'll see you in the neighborhood.